So in this video, to be different, what I'm going to do is go over Camille's abilities, which are came out and revealed. I'm going to have screenshots of the abilities as I describe them as well, in case the description enough isn't enough to kind of give you an idea of what they do. But to be different, I'm going to go over what I think about these abilities as an AD carry player, particularly someone that plays a lot of immobile AD carries. So I am going to try and remain unbiased in terms of saying, oh, this is stupid, this is terrible, etc, etc. But I am going to try and give my opinion of what it's going to probably be like playing against this character from that position. So without further ado, I'm going to go over the abilities first. So first of all, there's the passive, which is called Adaptive Defenses. And pretty much, Camille's basic attacks on champions grant a shield against her primary opponent's damage type. The shield's strength increases based on Camille's max HP. So in other words, what that means is, and in the screenshot, what you'll see is, there's Jinx and there's Victor. Jinx, an AD carry, physical damage. Victor, magic damage, he's a mage, etc, etc. What it means is, if she's attacking Jinx, for example, or just a physical damage type of champion, she'll gain, kind of think of like Morgana's black shield, but for AD, for physical damage. That's what she'll gain against champions like that. So you'll see the red shield. That's a physical damage shield. Jinx is going to do less damage to her if she tries to like duel her or something because there's a physical damage shield. It's funny that they use Jinx in these previews, but we're going to get to that in a second. And then in turn, of course, attacking Victor, you kind of get like the black shield. It's a magic shield that you get, so if he tries to trade with you, it's not going to be as successful. The idea, I guess, is like, she's a fighter. She's like going to try and get to your face and fight you. Both these champions, for example, have range. She's going to need a little bit extra help to be able to duel these champions in, or otherwise they could maybe kite her to death, or something like that, right? Now, as a AD carry player, yeah, I think that's actually kind of fair, because if you even with Jinx's minigun, which has a shorter range than the rocket launcher, it's still range versus melee, right? And the game kind of doesn't favor melee champions too much without doing something like this, having some sort of shield or health or some sort of gimmick to kind of help them out. I'm kind of okay with that, right? Because like, if you're on the other side of that coin, trying to get to that range, you know, champion, you're gonna need a little bit of extra help, especially against something like a Jinx or Kog'Maw, something that can really melt you if it's late enough in the game and they have a lot of DPS. But even Victor, he has enough bursts that he can just completely destroy somebody with a Lich Bane rush. So I mean, I'm actually okay with for that reason. I know what it's like playing that from the other side of the coin, and that can be very annoying. So I'm okay with that. I don't know if the shield strength needs to increase based on max HP because of a fear I have that we'll also get into later, but we'll just get on with the next ability. Precision Protocol. So Camille's next basic attack slashes the enemy for bonus physical damage and grants a short burst of movement speed, and for a brief period after the initial cast can be recasted for an additional strike, and for a short period of time, the ability's second attack will deal extra bonus damage and is partially converted into true damage. Okay, now we have all 9 yards. I was waiting for this to be built into the kit, of course, because that's kind of what a lot of the past champions and reworks and stuff have kind of getting nowadays. We need some true damage, and we need some extra bonus damage to convert it into true damage and additional strikes and movement speed and all this other stuff. Okay. So that's okay. Except it's probably not if you're, like, again, a mobile champion, because that's definitely what you need. You're not building any really defensive items early anyway, so now you just need true damage to burn you to death even faster. But even from a tank's perspective, I actually kind of want to know how tanks feel about just going against true damage. Like, you're itemizing all these armor items and stuff, and then Vayne is just still tearing through you, and just true damage, period. I don't know how I feel about that, but I'm not going to say it sucks, because again, it's probably about gap closing, right? Like, you probably get into these ranged characters, you just need to blow them up, because they might in turn blow you up, depending on how fed they are. It's a mechanic, or it's something that's useful, I guess, for dealing with fed champions, even though I'm biased against that, just because I feel like if you're going against a fed ranged character, they deserve to play a game where they get to live out being fed and ranged, like, but whatever. That's not necessarily terrible. I think that'll be useful for helping shut down characters and champions that are really hard to shut down when they are fed, in which case, the game shouldn't necessarily be, like, over, right? Like, oh, I guess we just better surrender because there's nothing we can do here. I guess you should have a fighting chance as long as you have, like, strategy and think about what to do to shut down the champion after all, right? So the W is called Tactical Sweep, and pretty much Camille gathers energy, then blasts it forward in a cone, dealing physical damage to all targets hit. Enemies caught in the outer half of the sweep will be greatly slowed and take additional damage based on their maximum HP and, of course, healing Camille in the process. I take it back. Before, we were only at about 7 yards, and now we're the full 9 yards. We have maximum HP damage, and we also have healing done. And this is playing into a fear that I'm going to talk about after we get past the ultimate, But the move itself, it's something of a skill shot, kind of like a cone skill shot. So it's not point and click. So I'm not terribly upset with some of these moves so far because she's a fighter. So if she's in melee range, it's not even a matter of point and click, right? It's just like you're in melee range against a melee character. This is what they're gonna do. This is something of a skill shot-esque kind of ability. So it is dodgeable, I guess is what I'm saying, without having to use flash to just get out of range of a point and click ability. So even as an immobile champion, that should be something that's relatively easy to deal with. You see them coming, just get moving. If you don't think you'll be able to dodge it in close range, just start running immediately, right? So the E, it's pretty much maneuver gear. If you've seen Attack on Titan, you know exactly what this kind of looks like, which is kind of cool. I'm not criticizing it. Actually, it's a pretty cool idea, right? Like the first cast is hookshot. You pretty much fire these like wire lines, grappling hooks even, from your hips. You attach them to a wall, and then you can pull yourself to that wall. And then there's a second cast, in which case, if you hit a wall first, you get bonus range for another dash, and you can dash to an enemy champion. And that in itself, I think, is kind of cool because it's like, hey, you have to land this first before you get the bonus dash range to try and dash to an enemy champion. Furthermore, it's kind of like Malphite. It's not like a point and click ability, in which case you dash the wall, then you point and click, and you're automatically to a champion. Because if you do dash to a champion and hit them, you're going to stun them. And so it's not a point and click stun, it's pretty much, hey, I have to land this dash kind of skill shot-esque ability to be able to have a stun, in which case, I think that's kind of okay. It does seem like it'd be kind of annoying to play against just because, let's say the hook's range is like 200, and then the bonus range is like 500, so like 500 range dash, give or take, because there are a lot of walls in Summoner's Rift, so it's not like it's going to be impossible to hit this move either. But it's not point and click, so I can be okay with it because it's like, again, it's dodgeable. As long as it's dodgeable, it doesn't matter how immobile of a champion I'm playing. I feel like at least I have a chance, or at least feel like it's fair. I guess that's the word I'm looking for. I feel like it's fair. Do I think I'm going to like it too much? Probably not, especially when they're first released, because like most champions, they're probably going to be super powerful and it's going to be really annoying. But nonetheless, okay, I can accept that. And then finally, Hextech Ultimatum. Camille leaps onto a targeted enemy champion, imprisoning them in a zone and knocking their allies away. While the ultimatum is active, the targeted enemy can't leave the area by any means. This area deactivates on its own after a brief period, or if Camille leaves the zone prematurely. In the zone, Camille's basic attacks deal additional magic damage. Of course. Now, the thing about this ability is, it kind of erases the previous arguments I'm making because it is a point and click, right? So here you go, you dash to the wall, you dash to an enemy champion, you miss them, but then you activate this point and click ability, in which case they can't get out. Think of it like Vhagar's cage, as far as I can tell. You can't even flash out of it. Like, you're just stuck in this cage and you just have to just try and 1v1 Camille at this point. And if you're like in this preview image, you're Jinx, that might not be what you can do at level 6, right? Like at level 6, and we're assuming because she's a solo laner or a jungler, she's going to be in head and level, so Jinx probably won't even be at level 6 yet. There's a good chance you could just go in and blow somebody up in the middle of lane if you're caught out too far, something like that. It's not going to be possible to, you know, fight them, which is kind of the point, right? Like at level 5, Jinx probably shouldn't be able to 1v1 at level 6 Camille. But my only actual issue with this is, what if you're in one of the other roles, right? Like, if you're the support, does that mean you can't escape the cage. So if you're Thresh, you can't throw like Jinx the Lantern and pull her out of it. But does that mean you also can't go into it either and try and help her out that way? Like, at what point, like, how do you peel, I guess, for someone that's been hit by this ability because it's point and click, right? Like, the other abilities are somewhat skill shots. So worst comes to shove, you can just throw yourself in front of the way, maybe. Like, if they're dashing towards your AD carry, you can just flash in front of it and you take the stun or something. In this particular case, you just have to stand there and kind of just watch your AD carry burn and just be like, this is fine. And then your AD carry, they're just dead. Like, you can't, or like do like skill shots and like long range abilities, they can't enter this cage. Like, it's like a shield kind of thing. Because in the preview image, Victor, for example, he's there, but he gets knocked out the cage. Does that mean he can't try and help Jinx by like shooting the death laser back into the cage and stuff like that? Again, I guess I want to know, and I guess we probably won't know until more gameplay stuff comes out. But really quick, the fear that I keep talking about, what's this fear that I have about this champion going over this kit, is ultimately, even as an immobile AD carry, they don't look like they're going to be super frustrating to play against. My biggest concern is just because of all the damage it seems they get in their kit for free already. Are they going to be yet another champion that can just build one damage item and then go full tank? Or even worse, just go full tank from the get-go, because they have this true damage, shield, healing, and all that stuff, you can pretty much just be like the next tank Echo. Now, maybe that's an overreaction. It probably is an overreaction. I'm pretty sure they have those worries in mind themselves. But that would be, if I had one fear, that would be it. Because then even as a mobile champion, it's just impossible to duel that, right? Like, I don't know. I think it's probably just an irrational fear on my part, but that would be like my one concern, I guess, if I had a concern. But that's all for this video. It's already ran too long. I apologize. But life is full of a lot of kinks, so I don't know which video will be next. So until next time, take care from the Fire Godai FS.